Division by one and two digit number. In the previous class, we have read how to divide numbers. Do you remember basic terms related to division? In a division sum, the number to be divided is called the dividend. The number by which we divide is called the divisor. The answer is called the quotient. The number which remains undivided is called the remainder. So if we divide 128 by 5, we get 25 as quotient and 3 as remainder. Here, 128 is the dividend and 5 is the divisor. Keep in mind, in a division, remainder is always less than the divisor. Now let us discuss some properties of division. When we divide a number by 1, the quotient is the number itself. For example, on dividing 25, 146, 2451 by 1, the quotients are 25, 146 and 2451 respectively. When we divide a number except 0 by itself, the quotient is 1. For example, on dividing 8 by 8, or 36 by 36, or 137 by 137, in each case, the quotient is 1. When we divide 0 by any number, the quotient is 0. Division by 0 is not allowed. Let us now discuss how we divide a 4-digit number by a 1-digit number. Consider 4803 divided by 7. Arrange the dividend and the divisor as shown. Start from the left, but 4 is less than 7. So take 4800s, that is 4800s. Divide 4800s by 7. 7 multiplied by 6 is equal to 42. So write 6 in the hundreds place of the quotient and 42 below 48. Subtract 42 from 48 to get 6. Bring down the 0 and divide 60 by 7. Also, 7 into 8 is equal to 56. So write 8 in the tens place of the quotient and 56 below 60. Subtract 56 from 60 to get 4. Bring down 3 and divide 43 by 7. Also, 7 multiplied by 6 is equal to 42. So write 6 in the ones place of the quotient and 42 below 43. Subtract 42 from 43 to get 1 as the remainder. So we get 686 as the quotient and 1 as the remainder. We can check the correctness of our division using the relationship quotient multiplied by divisor plus remainder is equal to dividend. Let us check the correctness of the above divisor. First, we multiply the quotient and the divisor. To this product, we add the remainder. We see that the sum is 4803, which is the dividend. Hence, our division is correct. When we divide by a 2-digit number, it is better to first estimate the quotient. Let us estimate the quotient for 56 divided by 18. 56 is rounded to 60 and 18 is rounded to 20. So the division becomes 60 divided by 20. To solve 60 divided by 20, think of 6 divided by 2. Since 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3, so 60 divided by 20 is also equal to 3. So 56 divided by 18 gives 3 as an estimated quotient. Estimate the quotient for 648 divided by 27. 648 is rounded as 600 and 27 is rounded as 30. So the division becomes 600 divided by 30. To solve 600 divided by 30, think of 60 divided by 3. Since 60 divided by 3 is equal to 20, so 600 divided by 30 is equal to 20. So 648 divided by 27 gives 20 as an estimated quotient. Now let us see how we divide by a two-digit number. Consider the division 7418 divided by 24. Write the dividend. Since the divisor is a two-digit number, we begin with the number formed by the first two leftmost digits of the dividend. This number is 74. Also, 24 multiplied by 3 is equal to 72. And 72 is less than 74. So, write 3 as the first digit of the quotient. Write 72 just below 74 and subtract to get 2. Now bring down 1 to the right of 2 to get 21 as the new dividend. Here, 24 multiplied by 1 is equal to 24, which is greater than 21. So we use 24 multiplied by 0 is equal to 0. We write 0 in the quotient and 0 below 21. Subtract 0 from 21 to get 21. Now bring down 8 to the right of 21 to get 218 as the new dividend. Also, 24 multiplied by 9 is equal to 216. So write 9 as the next digit of the quotient and 216 below 218. Subtract 216 from 218 to get 2 as the remainder. So 7418 divided by 24 gives us 309 as quotient and 2 as the remainder. Whenever we have to divide a number by 10, 100 or 1000, we can find the quotient and the remainder quickly just by looking at the dividend. Let us divide 532 by 10. We see that 2 is the remainder and 53 is the quotient. Again, divide 6019 by 10. Here, the remainder is 9 and the quotient is 601. From the above example, we can have the following rule. When a number or dividend is divided by 10, the quotient is obtained by removing the ones digit of the dividend. The ones digit of the dividend is the remainder. When we divide a number by 100, the quotient is obtained by removing the tens and ones digits of the dividend. The number formed by the two removed digits is the remainder. For example, on dividing 436 by 100, the quotient is 4 and the remainder is 36. Similarly, on dividing 72,194 by 100, the quotient is 721 and the remainder is 94. In the same pattern, we get the quotient and the remainder when the divisor is 1000 as follows. To divide a number by 1000, we simply remove the ones, tens and thousand digits from the dividend to get the quotient. These removed hundreds, tens and ones digits will be the remainder. For example, when we divide 2538 by 1000, the quotient is 2 and the remainder is 538. Similarly, on dividing 74,806 by 1000, we get 74 as quotient and 806 as the remainder.